Hello everyone, welcome you all for the presentation of materials for engineering. Today I am going to cover the 5th unit heat treatment process 6th session. In the previous session you have studied about heat treatment definition, purpose of heat treatment, mechanism of heat treatment, types of heat treatment process. So what is heat treatment? It is an operation or combination of operation, it involving the heating and cooling of metal in the solid state to produce the certain desired properties. So sometimes what happen, by producing the mechanical parts we are going to the some mechanical operation, that is bending, forging, drawing, etc. For all these operation it creates the internal stresses in the parts. So it is very important to release its internal stresses before it to use. For that we are going to the heat treatment process. The main purpose of heat treatment is to relieve the internal stresses, to soften the metal, to improve the hardness of the metal, to improve its machinability, refine its grain size and improve its mechanical properties. Some mechanisms also we have studied in that session, mechanisms of heat treatment. First one is heating the metal to the specified temperature. Second one is holding the metal at the increased temperature for specified period. Third one is cooling the metal according to the specified process. And in the types of heat treatment process, that is annealing, normalizing, hardening, tempering, case hardening, surface hardening, diffusion coating. These all the we have studied in the 5th session. Let's move on. So we'll study the first type of heat treatment, that is annealing process. What is annealing process? The steel parts are produced by the mechanical operations such as casting, rolling or drawing and extruding, etc. It develops the internal stresses and the changes their internal structure. So this renders them hard and brittle. So the steel parts which are produced by the mechanical operation, casting, rolling or drawing, extruding, etc. So idella operations aa parts mele some internal stresses na create madutte and also it will changes the structure of that part, the internal structure nu kuda change madutte. So id madodrind en agutte aa material parts it will become hard and brittle. So it is very important to release its internal stresses and to improve its internal structure. For that we are going to the annealing process. So why will carry the annealing process means, annealing is carried out for a such part to remove the its internal stresses and make them more ductile and the less brittle. So annealing process na navu enik martivi antandre, so idella mechanical process inda in internal stress and develop agirutte and also the internal structures in change agirutte. So adanna remove madodikke and that part na now ductile matte less brittle adanna tumba, it is very easy to machining ge easy ago tara aa part na now prepare madbeku. For that purpose we will carry the annealing process. So what is annealing? So annealing alli what we'll do, so annealing process alli en martivi, annealing consists of heating of steel parts to a temperature at or near the critical temperature, hold it at that temperature for a suitable time and then allow to cool slowly in the furnace itself. It means that, so annealing process alli, annealing heat treatment process alli will heat the steel parts, a steel part na up to the critical temperature, at or near the critical, upper critical temperature ga it will be near to that temperature, will heat that parts, will heating the will heat that part up to the critical temperature. Our temperature alini will hold that material at for the suitable time. One particular atwa adukku one suitable time ge our temperature alane our part na will leave it for some time and then allow to the cool slowly in the furnace itself. So avaga aa material na now cool agodike bidbeku. So now cooling process na will do it in a furnace alane will leave that material to cool down. So this is the annealing process. So the main mechanisms alli you have studied. The main mechanisms of the heat treatment process is to heat the material and leave the material at that temperature for a specified time and allow it to cool. So in the annealing heat treatment process alli will heat the first mechanism to annealing heat the steel part to the temperature at or near the critical temperature andre a critical temperature varugu will heat that steel parts and second process is to hold that temperature for a suitable time ondu particular time varugunu aa parts na will leave that and third mechanism is to cool down. So how will cool in the annealing process will cool down that steel parts in the furnace itself. It means that will not remove that parts, will leave that parts to cool down in the furnace itself. And the furnace alone will leave to cool down. Okay, this is the annealing process. So this is the annealing temperature curve. See, this is a annealing. So types, this is a process annealing and the full annealing. This will study in next slides in an. So this is the temperature curve. So this is the upper critical temperature for that will heat that material and then allow it to cool. Okay, this is a temperature curve for the annealing process. So the main purpose of annealing to soften the steel so that it may be more easily machined or cold work. So a first purpose is to a steel in it will become very hard agitu due to the some mechanical operation. We have to in annealing process it make it a soft and it is easily machined matte easy machine agutara will prepare it for the annealing process. And second one, to refine the grain size and the structures. So due to the mechanical operation in the internal stress develop agitu and internal structure kuda change agitu, that all will be improved. In agate it's a refined grain size na refine madate and structure na structural property nu kuda improvise madate like adrdu strength matte ductility na kuda improve madate. And the third purpose is to relieve the internal stresses that has been caused by the hot or cold working by the unequal contraction in the casting. Andre due to the hot work matte cold work agidrinda a material part mele in internal stresses in develop agitu aa internal stresses na release madodike will use the annealing process. Okay, so next fourth purpose is to alter the electrical, magnetic or any other physical properties adrudu electrical magnetic property matte ene on physical properties na kuda idu change madate for our suitable condition. Namde en suitable condition ide aa suitable condition ge it will alter its mechanical, magnetic and the physical properties. And to remove the gases trapped in the metal during initial casting andre initial casting en enu adralli inner en gas en produce agittu aa anta gases na kuda it will be removed. And the types of annealing in the heat treatment is first one is process annealing and the full annealing. Okay, we'll study these types. So process annealing, what is process annealing? Process annealing alli en martivi and in this process, so the steel is heated to a temperature below or close to the critical temperature and at this temperature for some time and then cooled slowly. So process annealingally will the steel part is heated below or close to the critical temperature, not at near to the critical temperature, at or near to the critical temperature. In the process annealing, will heat the steel part below or close to the critical temperature. Andre adr critical temperature ginta kelagadege will heat that materials. So this is a process annealing, and then held at that temperature for a suitable time and then cooled slowly. Adanna slow aagi cool aagodike will leave it. So in a process annealing, so the steel part is heated below or close to the critical temperature and held at this temperature for some time and then cooled slowly. So ee process what is this process will do? So this process causes the complete recrystallization in the steel which have been severely cold worked, and a new grain structure is formed. So due to the some mechanical operation, its internal structures also has been changed. ಅದರದ್ದು ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಈ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ. ಸೊ ಇದರದ್ದು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ರೀಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಗ್ರೇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಗ್ರೇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ನ ಆ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ಗಿಂತ ಕೆಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ವರೆಗೂ ಹೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ವಿಲ್ ಲೀವ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೂಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ಸಿಂದ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ರೀಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಒಂದು ನ್ಯೂ ಗ್ರೇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್. ಇನ್ ಅ ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್, ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ? ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ 30°C to 50°C ಅಬೋವ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಅಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೂಲ್ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸೊ ಇನ್ನ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವಿ, ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ನ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ಗಿಂತನೇ ಕೆಳಗಡೆಗೆ ವಿಲ್ ಹೀಟ್ ದ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ನ ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹೀಟ್ ದ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ 30°C to 50°C ಅಬೋವ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ಗಿಂತ 30°C ಅಥವಾ 50°C ವರೆಗೂ ವಿಲ್ ಹೀಟ್ ದಟ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಅಲೋವ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೂಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕೂಲ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ವೇರೀಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ 30°C to 200°C ಪರ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ವೇರೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ 30°C to 200°C ಪರ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್. ದ ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್. ಇನ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ? ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಅಲೋವ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೂಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ ಕೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇರಿ 30°C to 200°C ಪರ್ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ದಿಸ್ ಕೂಲ್ ರೇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ವೇರೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಮೇನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಸಾಫ್ಟನ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಹಾರ್ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಕಲ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್. ಆ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಕಲ್ ಆಪರೇಷನಿಂದ ಏನು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರಿಫೈನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೇನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಟು ರಿಲೀವ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಮತ್ತು ಫುಲ್ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಷನ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೇಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದೆನ್ 0.12 ದ ಅನಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ 875 to 925. and if the 0.12 to 0.25 carbon content, it is treated as mild steel. The temperature range is 840 to 970. 0.25 to 0.55 is a medium carbon steel. The annealing temperature range is 815 to 840 degrees Celsius. This all temperature is in a degree Celsius. Okay. So 0.55 to 0.80 the carbon content, then it is a high carbon steel. Then the annealing temperature range is 780 to 810 degree Celsius. 0.8 to 1.40 high carbon steel, the annealing temperature range is 760 to 780 degree Celsius. So depending upon the content or depending upon the types of steel, so the annealing temperature range also will be varied. As I already have told that the temperature range or that will be depends upon the content, carbon content of the or the types of the material, what we are using, what type of material we are using, on that basis we'll select the annealing temperature range. So these are the some table they have given, which have been used in the annealing process. The temperature range is varies like this. Okay, this is some videos related to that.
Achieving a flawless annealing process is an art requiring a precise combination of temperature, time, atmosphere, and controlled cooling.
The magnetic properties of electrical-grade steel are especially sensitive to stress. The annealing process removes stress from the core steel and is critical to ensuring that the core will deliver optimum accuracy and minimum excitation loss.
Our energy-efficient, state-of-the-art furnaces are custom-designed, in-house, specifically for annealing instrument transformer cores. Cores are tempered in a controlled atmosphere to prevent oxidation and scaling. Temperature escalation is time-controlled until reaching 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. The precise soak time is calculated based on mass and stack configuration.
Fully automated monitoring systems in our furnace control center measure and control temperature, atmosphere, and cycle time. Constant, real-time automated monitoring systems ensure that a perfect anneal is achieved for each and every core. After the process, this is confirmed by excitation testing to verify that the volt amps per pound loss ratio are within specifications.
Okay, which video you have seen, this is a video link. So next move to the multiple choice questions. The first one is that dash consists of heating steel parts to a temperature at or near the critical temperature. Near the critical temperature 900 degrees Celsius and then allowed to cool in a furnace itself. This process is annealing, normalizing, hardening and tempering. And the answer is annealing, because in an annealing process will steel parts are heated at or near the critical temperature, that is 900 degrees Celsius around, so and then allowed to cool in a furnace itself. So in an annealing process we'll leave the steel part to cool down in a furnace itself. So the answer is annealing. And the second question is, the main objects of annealing in a heat treatments are to soften the steel, to refine the grain size, to relieve the internal stresses, all of the above? And the answer is all of the above, because in a annealing process, these all the will happen in the parts. It will be softened the steel, it also refine the grain size, and also it will relieve the internal stresses. This is a main purpose to relieve the internal stresses is the main purpose of the heat treatment process. In annealing process also, it will relieve the internal stresses, it will refine the grain size, it will soften the steel. So the answer is all of the above. The main object is all of the above. And the third question is, annealing process consists of heating of steel parts and then allowed to cool slowly in a furnace itself. The answer is true or false. As all of you know, it's a true, because in annealing process, heating the steel parts and then allowed to cool slowly in a furnace itself. It is true. Next one is, the process of DAS process consists of heating steel 30 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius above the upper critical temperature for steel and then allowing it to cool slowly in the furnace itself. And the answer is normalizing, hardening, full annealing, and none of the above. And the answer is full annealing, because in a full annealing process, the heating the steel 30 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius above the upper critical temperature for steel and then allow it to cool slowly in the furnace itself. So the answer is full annealing. In a full annealing process, this all will happen. Next, come to the conclusion of this session, that is annealing, purpose of annealing, annealing temperature range, and application. These all we have studied in this session. Just briefly go through it. And annealing process consists of steel parts at a temperature at or near the critical temperature, that is around 900 degrees Celsius. Hold it at that temperature for a suitable time and then allow to cool slowly in the furnace itself. This is a annealing process. The main purpose of annealing is to soften the steel, to refine the grain size, to relieve the internal stresses, to alter the electrical magnetic properties, to remove the gases. These are all the some purpose of the annealing process. So the types of annealing, that is a process annealing and the full annealing. In process annealing, we'll heat the steel parts to a temperature, it's below the critical temperature, and the critical temperature ginta kelagadege will heat the material and then allow it to cool. This is a process annealing. In a full annealing process, we'll heat the steel parts 30 to 50 degrees Celsius above the critical temperature, then hold it for the some time and then allow it to cool. This is a full annealing process. This all we have studied. In the next session, that is seventh session, we'll study about the one type of heat treatment process, that is normalizing, purpose of normalizing, normalizing temperature range, and application. This all we'll study in the next session. Thank you.